Let's get to know more about knowledge acquisition. Knowledge starts from data to information, then knowledge. Data are raw facts, figures, and measurements. Information are refinement and use of data to answer specific questions. Knowledge is refined information put into context. Wisdom is applying knowledge. The source of knowledge can be documented, such as from books, journals, procedures, films, and databases. It can also be undocumented, such as from people's knowledge and expertise, people's minds, as well as other senses. Types of knowledge includes facts, for example, cats have paws. Relations, like Sarah is the mother of Ellen. Rules, like if it rains, bring umbrella. Concepts, for example, for all X and Y. And procedures, like first do this, then that. To build an expert system, knowledge will need to be acquired from various sources. According to Buchanan et al., knowledge acquisition is defined as the transfer and transformation of potential problem-solving expertise from some knowledge source to a program. This basically means a process where knowledge from expertise is being extracted for the use of a knowledge system. It requires a knowledge engineer to mediate between the expert and the knowledge base, where they elicit knowledge from the expert, refines it in conjunction with the expert, and represents the knowledge in the knowledge base using a suitable knowledge structure. Knowledge can be acquired using various techniques. Firstly, using interview and protocol analysis, where the domain expert is asked to think aloud while solving problem. Literature review, concept sorting, and diagram-based techniques. Surveys and questionnaires, which is useful in gathering quantitative factual knowledge. Generating prototypes. And observation, which gives a better picture of the solution strategy. Stages of acquisition. Let's say we want to build an expert system on plants. We first need to define the task, then find a suitable expert and a knowledge engineer and get the expert's statement. For example, the begonia likes bright light and survives best outdoors in natural sunlight, whereas ivy prefers dim light and is probably better indoors lit by a light bulb. Next, the knowledge engineer will interpret and understand the knowledge provided by the experts and build a domain dictionary. And finally, develop a model of the reasoning involved and how it is applied. This can be a decision tree, flowchart, production rules, or others. In this example, you can see three decision trees based on the expert's statement. Knowledge acquisition does have problems. Experts often have a subconscious hostility or fear to providing information. Many also have great difficulty in articulating knowledge. Human knowledge is complex, unstructured, and usually ill-formulated. It is also hard for individual problem experience to be transformed to abstracted rules in a systematic manner and in a rational, structured form. Often, the expert is so close to the problem under consideration that they have difficulty in seeing it objectively. The situation is worse when the knowledge sources comprises of several experts. Although with problems, knowledge acquisition is still an important process in developing expert systems. That's all we have for now. Thanks for watching!